Right, so there's been some breaking news in the jailbreaking world. Ty G have managed to finally jailbreak, or at least release it, because I'm sure it's been jailbroken for quite a while. But they've finally released publicly the jailbreak tool from 8.1.3 all the way up to 8.3, which is the latest version that's out at the moment. So now we're able to pretty much jailbreak any device that is available on the market. So let's go ahead and show you guys how to do that. There'll be a lot of relevant links to all of the things that you need, as well as tutorials on the Ty G website, as well as I really recommend checking out their Twitter, which everything will be down below, as well as checking out my own Twitter as well, as just a quick shameless plug. But let's get into the thick of things. So what you've got to do is download the Ty G jailbreak tool. It's about 68 megabytes, and we have it over here, unrazed to about 72 or 70 megabytes, and all we do is just open that up. Here comes iOS 8.3. Now, of course, like your typical jailbreaks, what you've got to do is just make sure that in your settings, you've got your passcode completely turned off. And if you have your iPhone, your Find My iPhone on your iPhone, make sure you turn that off as well. Now, you should be almost ready to go. Another thing that you do need to make sure that you've got is iTunes at a older version, which I currently have. Actually, no, we don't want to go to help. We want to go to about iTunes and version 12.0.1.26. Download link will be in the description, so you guys can go ahead and check that out. And you do need this version, otherwise Ty G will come up with a problem. All right, so let's go have a look at what we're doing now. Jailbreak 8.3, open up the program, make sure you've got everything connected to your computer. I have the iPad Air, which I've just recently bought, but unfortunately it came with the older newest firmware, so I wasn't able to jailbreak and I was waiting it out for this. So let's get cracking. Let's go press start. I'll do the jailbreak, make sure it's all working, plugged in and all of that. It's restarting the device, says please wait. I did read that a lot of people have been having problems with the jailbreak stuck at 20%. So let's hope that this is not going to be a complete fail. We should be good though. I'll probably just go ahead. Well, my iPhone or my iPad has just restarted. We'll have to wait and see what will happen. Unfortunately, I'm not able to record the screen while we're doing this as well. So here we go. Restart success. Continue to jailbreak. Let's hope it goes a little bit faster than this. All right, well, we're back to 99%. Only took us about a minute or two just to jailbreak it. The device should be restarting now, and indeed it is, and jailbreak has succeeded. Thank you for using Ty G jailbreak tool. Please enjoy your jailbroken device. Now, as I did say, we did close that. I do really recommend checking out the Ty G Twitter page, because they have a lot of important information for you guys, and seemingly, it says that Cydia Substrate is not compatible with iOS 8.3 at the moment. So we're going to have to wait until that gets fixed up. But other than that, let's go have a look at our device. All right, so we're into our device, and let's just go quickly check out our settings just to show you guys what we're on. We are at version 8.3.12F. 6.9. All right, so let's get out of here and let's swipe all the way over to the side. And here we go. We've got Cydia, as well as that 3000 Japanese or Chinese, sorry, program that we did install as well. So people pretty much only need Cydia. Now let's go ahead and open that up and that'll just do its own thing. But I think that's just about it for this video. It is very late as well. The jailbreak just got released, so we're doing this literally in the middle of the night at 12 a.m. But until next time though, guys, I'll see you later.